Hi guys, postman's been rotating LED light and module. Okay, value 68 cents and 1 cent. Oh, 10 cents, so it adds up to 78 cents. Okay, let's have a look. Well, okay, what does that do? That is a little relay, integrated circuit, potentiometer, light dependent resistor, LDR. So I think that's a little module that light sensitive, operates a relay, so you can operate what you like from it. So that's what that one is. And then this one, a fidget spinner. Yeah, okay. Oh, before I open it, I'll put something underneath so we can see what it is. Before we lose track of that one totally, I will do something with it, but not just at this moment. Right, fidget spinner with flashing LEDs. So we've got a bearing to go in the middle. Okay. Right, I might have to check the seller's site because I think there was actually instructions on how to put it together. But I think it's pretty straightforward. I think we got a row of LEDs to go up and down there, a chip to go on there, and some resistors to go on there. Oh, and pads for the button cells to go there and there to balance it. Well, what goes there? Switch, I should think. It's all surface mount stuff. That's our LEDs. That looks like our resistors. Four of them. There. That's our switch. Oh, I wonder which is the best way to fit them. If we fit them that way round, yeah, and push the button cells in from the outside. And you might need a bigger soldering iron to solder them. Over there, isn't it? Yes, I might have to go and watch the, I think there's actually a video on the assembly process. Although, to be honest, that looks fairly straightforward. Nice bearing. I think you have to I was going to say super glue it. No, but you don't. I remember watching the video. You actually solder that in place. So you are going to need a significantly more robust soldering iron to get that in place. Otherwise, yeah, you can't use the same one that you're using for those. Right, I'll better go and watch the video to see how I'm supposed to put it together. Right, I've checked the video, and the very last thing you do is fit that. So we can get on and do the rest of this. I've got my fan here to blow the fumes away. So that might make a noise on the camera. I'll start off with my Antec 18 watt soldering iron, see how I get on with that. It might be too much to do the little ones, and we might have to swap to a different soldering iron. Let's have a look. So, LEDs, can't even get them out of the package. Right, the LEDs. The camera will pick it up. They've got a little notch out the corner, which, looking at the picture, means they go that way around. This is going to be fun, isn't it? I really do need a smaller soldering iron, I think. Imagine doing that. I'll try it, it might work. If it doesn't, I've got a much smaller soldering iron. Let's just try putting a bit of solder on there. No, not hot enough yet, I have to wait for a second. We can't even see this, can we? Right, so I've got solder on those tags. Now let's see what we can do with this. So there's a little corner out of it, top right, as I'm looking at it now. I'm looking at the video. It goes like that. To be honest, I'm not very confident, but we'll give it a try. Well, that didn't work. Oh, it was there and I made a mess of it. Right, they're in place. Let's see if we can flow a bit more. mess of that. That's no good. Come on. Gonna have to wick that off in a minute if that doesn't come off in a second. No, that doesn't want to come off. Come on. All right, we'll move on. We'll worry about that one in a minute. And that one wrong as well. I don't think I even needed to worry about this side. That side. I'll go and do these again. I'm just going to try and clean that bit of surplus solder off. Well, I'm not happy with what I've done there, but we'll leave it. So we need three of these resistors. Which I can't get out of the pack. Right. And right way up. You can probably tell I'm well out of my comfort zone here. Doesn't help that I can hardly see what I'm doing, even with my glasses on. Try that. Okay, so that's those resistors in place. Now the chip. Okay, there's a little dot down at that end. It's supposed to go that way round. Get that one leg in place. Oh, come on. And we should be able to do the others easily. Except the camera can't see what I'm doing. Okay, that's done that one. Still not happy with my original LEDs. Okay, switch. Okay. Now these. And right way round. Let's give it a bit of starter. Right, do you think this will get too hot to hold? Probably is the answer. Well, I'm going to go and get some CR232s and test it before we worry about trying to fit the bearing in. Well, they all lit up. Bit of a mixture of colours. I wonder if they're random colours because I haven't got all the soldering done properly. Oh yeah. So I've got to do a bit of tacking along there with the soldering iron to try and sort them out. Well, I resoldered some of those LEDs and they seem to be looking better now. I haven't soldered the bearing in place yet. I'm just going to give it a spin. So we've got some idea of what the patterns are. I don't know if the camera is picking it up. But it is doing lots of pretty patterns. Right, I can't imagine for 1 minute I'll get enough heat there to solder this in place, but I'll give it a try, and if it doesn't work then I'll have to change to a different soldering iron. So we've got the plates underneath to lift it up just a little bit. I expect for demonstration purposes it doesn't need to be a perfect soldering job. Just needs to hold it in place while I try and spin it. Yeah, it's taken all the heat away from the soldering iron much too quickly. I changed up to a decent 80 watt soldering iron, so we've got a nice solder joint round there now, holding it in place. So now we take the protective cover off somehow. Sounds like somebody's got fireworks out there again. November the 16th, this is, I'm doing this. Well after fireworks night, which is November the 5th in the UK. So that's going to go around there. stays on that side, that one goes on that side. Is that right? I would have thought there'd have been some spacers under there. I'll go and look at the picture again in a minute, but I'll put these on. Ah, yeah, I expect they were supposed to. Yeah, right, that makes more sense. Talk to myself for a minute. I reckon that's, they're the spacers. Probably don't need the fan on now, do I? Be a bit quieter then. I wonder why one is plastic and the other two are metal. Oh, weight distribution thing, probably. Okay, there's our fidget spinner. It's not very well balanced, to be honest. We need batteries back in there, don't we? That would help. That would help with the balance as well, wouldn't it? Oh yes, that's much better. So, switch it on. Turn some of those other lights off. Yes. Well, I hope the camera's recording this. I can see it. No idea whether the camera's getting it. I won't know till I play it back. a spin. So yeah, there we go. A flashing LED fidget spinner. Just what you always wanted. There'll be a link in the video description, or at least, no, there'll be a description in the video description that you can paste into your online store of choice. And it should find it for you. I use eBay, but obviously there's lots of other online stores that sell stuff. But it does appear to have worked. Job done.
Hey, thanks for watching. There's plenty of videos on my main channel with more added daily, so don't forget to subscribe and enable the notifications to keep you up to date with my new releases. You can help keep my channel running by donating $1 on Patreon to buy me coffee. You can always find more information in the video description. Thanks again for watching.